Lawrence Motorsports and Farming Channel. I have just finished cutting the first hay of 2019. I tried to make a video driving along while I was actually cutting, but then a camera bumped into something and corrupted the data, so now you're seeing this instead. I'll try making a video like that again in a month or so, when I come back here to do the second crop here. I don't know if you guys can see this on camera or not, but I did notice some dandelions in here, which we certainly don't like seeing it on hay fields any more than you like seeing it on a lawn. But one advantage of a hay field now is that when they do come, you only see it in the first crop, and then once you get the first crop made and get them off, then you generally don't see them anymore the rest of the year. Some might think I'm a little too early this year, cutting the first crop this early or at this time, but hopefully there's enough of a window yet with little or no rain to where we can still get this put up decent. Not only do I have the opportunity to make a direct sale with some of these bales to somebody by making my own hay before he's able to make his own, but another thing by doing it now rather than later is that I would have waited a couple weeks or so to cut the first crop, then I'd be lucky to get three crops, whereas by cutting it now I have the opportunity to get four crops or possibly even five, but I don't know how likely that really is. But to get four crops, I know it's pretty likely. So yeah, where we're driving now is one of the thicker areas of the field. On some of the lower spots, whereas when you get up this little hill here, if you really call it a hill or not, it's more of an incline that levels off again later, and it starts to get a little thinner again. Probably won't get as much volume by cutting it now, but the overall quality is going to be better than if I would have waited a couple weeks or so. So say of 2019 has been cut. This is the only sort of alfalfa field that I'll be able to cut this year for the most part. A couple places where I seeded wheat a couple weeks ago. You know, I also went back and seeded some hay. But if I get anything at all, it'll be more in the fall, you know. Get the wheat harvested off and then the hay starts growing. Yeah, for the most part, well, we can only count on the newly seeded stuff to give us hay next year. Usually we were able to get a crop from stuff that we just seed, but you know, it doesn't always work that way. So there, you can see I'm close to one of the fields that I seeded wheat and followed behind with the seeder to put hay in there. I got videos done of both of those things that you guys can go back and watch. But we finally got some hay cut in 2019 now. We're not quite done with the spring planting just yet, but you know, at least we're getting something done by getting hay cut while we're waiting for things to dry out some more so that we can finish the spring planting. And when I'm able to get back to, you know, field work and planting, then I'll get as much video footage as I can of that. So, I mean, I knocked down a little chunk of grass here before I call it good with the hay, with cutting hay. Thank you guys for watching my videos. I certainly appreciate it. Be sure to hit the like button, and if you haven't already, be sure to hit the subscribe button, and I'll catch you later.